that's amazing!
Catherine here. It's not common to read in medical literature of end-stage chronic kidney disease patients that are able to get out of dialysis. And it's even less common to read about patients not needing dialysis anymore thanks to a single, natural remedy. But it happened. It happened in 2003 in a study that was published in the Journal of Nutritional and Environmental Medicine. That was a large and extremely significant study. It proved that significantly increasing the quantity of antioxidants in the body can stop and even reverse kidney damage. The antioxidant these patients were given and that got them out of dialysis is incredibly surprising. And also in today's video, I will show you exactly how you can benefit from this incredible molecule which is commonly used and available. This antioxidant is one of the reasons why today a lot of research is still being done in the direction of stopping CKD with antioxidant therapies. And the assumption behind that study was clear. It has been observed times and times again that antioxidant levels are deficient in most CKD patients. This means that there is oxidative stress in the kidneys. Now, oxidative stress is a term so overused by mass media and advertising that it has lost all of its meaning. We almost consider it a mundane thing, but it isn't. So to understand how these 9 patients got out of dialysis, we must first understand what oxidative stress actually is. What is oxidative stress and why it causes kidney damage? Excess oxidative stress is one of the main ways diseases such as diabetes and high blood pressure damage the kidneys. You see, oxidative stress happens when there are more free radicals in the body than the body itself can handle. Free radicals are highly reactive molecules that are a normal part of metabolism but cause damage at a cellular level when left unchecked. This can lead or contribute to a number of diseases: cancer, neurological diseases, Parkinson's disease, Alzheimer's disease, even depression. And oxidative stress can also cause chronic inflammation. And obviously, it plays a crucial role in diseases such as diabetes, high blood pressure, heart and kidney problems. I mean, oxidative stress is what causes aging in the human body, basically. And the body has its own ways to take care of excess free radicals. But can you guess which organ is supposed to handle these incredibly dangerous molecules? Yup, you got it right! The kidneys. This is why today antioxidant therapies are one of the main areas of research when it comes to slowing down kidney disease. Now that we have a better understanding about how oxidative stress works, it may be clearer why those 9 patients were able to lower their creatinine at the point they didn't need dialysis anymore. You see, the study we are looking at today is one of the few serious studies aimed at getting patients out of dialysis. This was a pretty large, double-blind, placebo-controlled study. It involved 97 participants, all of them in stage 5 of CKD. Half of them were in dialysis. A significant decrease in creatinine levels was expected, and it was observed. Patients in stage 5 not on dialysis lowered their creatinine on average by 1.1 points. Patients in dialysis lowered their creatinine on average by 2.8 points. Yes, these are incredible numbers! And most incredible part is that this result was expected. You see, these patients were instructed by researchers to look out for signs that they didn't need dialysis anymore. What sign will tell a patient that he doesn't need dialysis anymore? These patients took their instructions pretty seriously. Smoking was completely stopped by all patients. They were also told to keep taking all the medications they were previously prescribed, including those to manage blood pressure, anemia, and diabetes. And they were monitored weekly for the first 4 weeks. What the researchers wanted to see was a significant decrease in serum creatinine. When a patient had a decrease in creatinine of 2 mg per dL, They were instructed to decrease dialysis frequency too, and many of them were started on dialysis recently enough, they were still making urine, and increasing urine output would have been the other factor. After 4 weeks, of the 21 dialysis patients in the antioxidant group, 4 decreased their dialysis from twice weekly to once weekly. These 4 dialysis patients plus 5 other patients were able to completely stop dialysis after 8 weeks of antioxidant treatment. Now, this is just incredible, and I bet you want to know exactly what they used to achieve this. What they used in this study is a powerful antioxidant called coenzyme Q10 or CoQ10. What is CoQ10? CoQ10, also known as ubiquinone, is a vitamin-like nutrient that's in every cell of your body. Every living cell, human, animal, or plant contains Q10. Its other name is ubiquinone to reflect its ubiquitous distribution. It's essential for energy production. Take the Q10 out of the cell and you have a cell that has as much potential as V8 engine without spark plugs, a dead engine. Health conditions like heart disease, brain disorders, diabetes, and cancer have been linked to low levels of CoQ10. It's even more important for the health of your kidneys because it is an incredibly powerful, almost miraculous molecule. And while CoQ10 is especially useful for those in the advanced stages, it may actually benefit everyone. So, very important question. What makes CoQ10 so good for kidney health? The kidneys contain a very high volume of blood. Toxins are circulating through them at any given time. This creates a constant wear and tear situation, a constant pressure the kidneys have to withstand. As we have seen, this is called oxidative stress. It may cause kidney disease to progress at a much faster rate if left unchecked. This is why researchers are testing CoQ10 as a way to prevent CKD from developing or to reverse it. And CoQ10 is also incredibly powerful against high blood pressure. In a meta-analysis of clinical trials published on the Journal of Hypertension, CoQ10 brought down blood pressure of the participants by up to 17 over 10 millimeters of mercury. Yes, an incredible result! And this can be especially useful today because we know now that most blood pressure medications actually damage the kidneys. By the way, if you want to know more about this issue, my video up here is for you! And it's clear that the effects this coenzyme has on the kidneys are powerful. As we have seen, taking CoQ10 may even reverse kidney disease in patients already in dialysis. Okay guys, time to see exactly how to take CoQ10, in what doses, and for how long. Before that, I have one really important thing to show you. There is a correlation between cholesterol and CoQ10 all patients with high cholesterol levels should know about. CoQ10 as a remedy against cholesterol. People with high cholesterol tend to have lower levels of CoQ10, so CoQ10 has been proposed as a treatment for high cholesterol. There is some evidence it may reduce side effects from conventional treatment with cholesterol-lowering drugs called statins, which reduce natural levels of CoQ10 in the body. Lipitor, Altoprevlesco, all these are known to lower CoQ10 levels in the body. Taking CoQ10 supplements can bring levels back to normal. Plus, studies show that CoQ10 may reduce the muscle pain associated with statin treatment. And while I always encourage you to consult your doctor before taking any new remedy, this one is incredibly helpful, so don't disregard it. I mean, it doesn't just save patients from dialysis, it also lowers blood pressure more effectively than medications. It fights high cholesterol and will also protect you from the dangers associated with taking statins, an incredibly common prescription medication. Okay guys, let's see now the best way to take CoQ10 for kidney health. In most studies, dosage of CoQ10 range from 30 milligrams to 200 milligrams administered over periods of 4 to 12 weeks. While starting with the lowest dosage may work, this supplement is very safe as we have seen, and especially those in the advanced stages will find more benefit with a higher dose. Taking 60 milligrams 3 times daily of CoQ10 seems to be the most effective way. Since CoQ10 is fat soluble, it's good to take it with food so it has a better absorption rate. Always be sure to take it with something healthy. A salad with olive oil is an example of a good healthy fat that would help CoQ10 be better absorbed into the system and make its benefits much more quickly and easily attainable. Remember that it may take 4 to 12 weeks to see changes in your blood test. Now, in the study we have seen in the beginning of the video that dose administered were higher than that. Test subjects received 180 mg of coenzyme Q10 3 times daily for a total of 540 mg a day. And while none of them had serious problems, we must understand that side effects increase exponentially with the dose, so I don't recommend taking a dose this large without explicit approval from your doctor. Another very important thing to know, this supplement may have some very mild side effects such as an upset stomach or diarrhea. Usually, dividing the total daily dose by taking smaller amounts 2 or 3 times daily instead of a large amount at all once can help reduce side effects. The only serious interaction this supplement has is with anticoagulants such as warfarin. It may make them less effective, so consult your doctor, especially if you are taking anticoagulants. What if you don't want to take another pill? What foods are high in CoQ10? Soybeans. Soybean products such as tofu, soy milk, and soy yogurt are a valuable source. Soybeans also have many other vitamins and minerals, as well as CoQ10. Boiled soybeans have 1.2 mg per 100 grams. Other soy products contain less, with tofu at 0.3 mg and soy milk at 0.25 mg. Also consider broccoli. Along with many vitamins and minerals, a lot of vegetables contain CoQ10. Among them, broccoli has high CoQ10 content, 0.6 to 0.8 mg per 100 grams. And nuts and seeds. Along with protein, heart healthy fats, and other important nutrients, nuts and seeds provide CoQ10 as well. Pistachios have 2 mg of CoQ10 per 100 gram serving. Peanuts have 2.6 mg. And sesame seeds have 1.7 mg. These quantities are, however, much smaller than what you can get from supplements. Now, guys, it's clear that antioxidants are key to protect the kidneys. But CoQ10 is not the only source of antioxidants. There are vitamins and other natural compounds that can be extremely useful in improving your antioxidant status and consequently your kidney health. In my video up here, I've shared with you what they are. And this is all for today. Thank you for watching. God bless.